you can now infuse the data security controls that you're used to with Microsoft 365 Copilot into your own custom-built AI apps and agentic solutions, even those running in non-Microsoft clouds. In fact, today I'll show you how we are helping developers and data security teams work together to prevent some of the biggest challenges around data leaks, oversharing, and compliance during AI interactions so that you can start secure with code-integrated controls that free you up and make it seamless for you as a developer to focus on building secure apps and agents, while knowing that potential users and their activities with work data will be kept secure. All of which is made possible with Microsoft Purview controls built into Azure AI Foundry, along with the new developer SDK that can be used to protect data during AI interactions, where protections can vary based on specific user context, even when apps are running in non-Microsoft clouds, which ultimately helps your data in apps and agents stay secure as policies evolve, while providing you as a security admin the visibility to evolve protections, to protect against leaks and risky insiders to maintain control of your data, prevent data oversharing to unintended recipients, and govern AI data and compliance of your industry and regional requirements by default. This approach makes it simple for you as a developer to translate the requirements of your data security teams as you build your apps using the Microsoft Purview SDK. In fact, let me show you an example of an AI app that's protected by Microsoft Purview. This is an AI-powered company chat app. It's a sample that you can find on GitHub, and it's using Azure AI Foundry services on the backend for large language model and Cosmos DB to retrieve relevant information based on a user's prompt. I'm signed in as a user on the external vendor team. Now I'm going to write a prompt that adds sensitive information with a credit card. And immediately I see a response that this request and prompt violates our company's sensitive information policy, which was set in Microsoft Purview, so our valuable information is protected. But the real power here is that the controls are user context aware too. It's not just blocking all credit cards, because there are easier ways to do that in code or with system prompts. Let me show you the same app without code changes for another user. I'm logged in as a member of the customer support engineering team, and I'm allowed to interact with credit card numbers as part of my job. So I'm going to write the same prompt. Now I'll submit it. And you'll see the app generates an appropriate response. And nothing changed in the app. The only change was my user context. And that was an example of a prompt being analyzed prior to sending it to the application so that it could generate a response. Let me show you another example that proactively prevents data oversharing based on the information retrieval process used by the app. I'm still logged in with the user's account on the customer support engineering team, and I'll prompt our app to send me information for recent transactions with Rel Cloud with the payment information to look at a duplicate charge. This takes a moment, looks up the transaction information in our Cosmos DB backend, and it's presenting the results to me. In this case, access permissions and protections have been applied using Microsoft Purview to the backend data source. And because our user account has permissions to that information, they received the response. This time, I'm signed in again as a user on the external vendor team. Again, I'll write the same prompt. And because I shouldn't and do not have access to retrieve that information, the app tells me that it can't respond. Again, it is the same app without any code changes, and my user context prevented me from seeing information that I shouldn't be able to see. As a developer, these controls are simple to integrate into your app code, and you don't need to worry about the policies themselves or which user should be in scope for them. Let me show you. This is the code behind our app. First, you can see that it's registered with Microsoft Entra. To help connect the app with both organizational policies and the identity of the user interacting with the app for user context so that it can apply the right protection scope. This is all possible by using the access tokens once the user has logged in. The app then establishes the API connection with Microsoft Purview to look at the protection scopes API, as well as the process content API, so that it can check whether the submitted prompt or the response is allowed or not, based on existing data security, access, and compliance policies. Based on what's returned, the app either continues or informs the user of the policy violation. Now that you've seen what's behind the app, let me show you the actual API interactions between our app and Microsoft Purview. And for that, I'll use a sample code that we've also published to GitHub to view the raw API responses in real time. This is the Purview API Explorer app. This is connected to the Microsoft Graph, as you can see with the request URI. I can use it to view protections and even view how content gets processed in real time, which I'll do here. Once the user logs in, you'll see that with the first API for protection scopes, the application will send the user content and application token, as well as the activities that the app supports, like upload text and download text, as noted here, for our prompts. Once the request is sent to the API, Purview responds back to the application to tell it what to do, in this case, for uploading and downloading text. The application will wait for Purview's response prior to displaying it back to the user. Now I'll go to start a conversation. And on the left in the request body, you can see my raw prompt again with sensitive information contained in the text along with other metadata properties. I'll send the request. On the right, I can see the details of the content response from the API. So in this case, it found a policy match and responded with the action restricted access and the restriction action to block. And that's what you'd need to know as a developer to protect your AI apps. Then, as a data security admin, for everything to work as demonstrated, there are a few things you'll need configured in Microsoft Purview. First, to protect against data loss of sensitive or high-value information, like I showed using credit cards, you will need data loss prevention policies in place. Second, to help prevent oversharing with managed database sources, like I showed from Cosmos DB, which also works with SQL databases, you will configure information protection policies. This ensures that your database instances are labeled with corresponding access protections applied. Then, for visibility into activities with your connected apps, all prompt and response traffic is recorded and auditable. And for apps and agents running on Azure AI Foundry, it's just one optional setting to light up native Microsoft Purview integration. In fact, here's the level of visibility that you get as a data security admin. In DSPM for AI, you can see interactions and associated risks from your AI line of business apps running on Azure and other clouds once they are enlightened with Microsoft Purview integration. Here you can see user trends, applicable protections, compliance, and agent count. And across the broader Microsoft Purview solutions, all activity and interactions from your apps are also captured and protected, including audit search, so that you can discover all app interactions, communication compliance for visibility into inappropriate interactions, and insider risk management as part of activities that establish risk. Integrating your apps with Microsoft Purview's SDK provides the control to free you up and make it seamless for you as a developer to focus on building secure apps and agents. At the same time, as a data security admin, it gives you continuous visibility to ensure that AI data interactions remain secure and compliant. To learn more, check out aka.ms/Microsoft Purview SDK. We've also put links to both sample apps in the description below to help you get started. Keep checking back to Microsoft Mechanics for the latest updates, and thank you for watching.